Joining me now, John Jerabek, who was coached by Dennis Hastert in high school. John, I appreciate you joining us. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. Thank you.
You and your two brothers all wrestled under Hastert. That was at Yorkville High School. You also had him as a teacher. What was he like as a coach and a teacher?
He was, you know, a really easy guy to talk to. He was kind of a disciplinarian. He required, you know, the best out of you. He demanded the best out of you, and you know, his wrestling teams kind of show that. I thought he was a real decent guy, always real good for his students and good for his wrestlers.
Was he a role model, you think, to young men at the time?
Oh, definitely, yeah. He was definitely a role model. I mean, this is one of the things that really sticks with me is the four years that I spent at Yorkville High School, you know, wrestling under Dennis Hastert. Mm-hmm. It was something that, you know, stuck with me, and I'll never forget. I think it really, really shaped me. Him along with wrestling, you know, it teaches you individuality, responsibility, and, you know, that you're responsible for the outcome in each and every thing you do and in the matches that you have each night. So,
yeah. So you're proud of where you've come so far in life, and you said that's due in part to him. But what about when you heard about these allegations? What did you think?
Yeah, it's quite a mystery to me. I like every other Yorkville resident, I'm sure, was just shocked. It was very surprising, very hard to believe. And I know that, you know, there's still a lot that isn't known, but it was shocking, yes. Yeah.
Is there anything that you can think about when you look back on this in retrospect that would give you any sort of clue that Dennis Hastert might be capable of this type of behavior?
No, Don, absolutely not. I mean, you know, he did a lot for the kids, the wrestlers and the students. I mean, we went, my older brother went to the Bahamas and scouts with him. I went to Colorado. You know, he took his wrestlers to Colorado, Rocky Mountain Wrestling Camp. We drove out there. I think he footed a lot of that from his own pocket. You know, we stayed out there a week. There was a lot of opportunity to see something like that, but I never even thought about anything like that because I never saw any behavior that
and no
that
rumor,
looked
no
like that.
No talk about anything like that about him
in the locker room. I mean, with the other wrestlers. I mean, I've talked to a couple other of the wrestlers, and we're all the same. I mean, we all can't believe it. There was never anything back then that would really indicate any behavior like that.
Mm-hmm. Have you seen him or spoken to him since you graduated high school?
I have, yeah. I mean, after high school, you know, wrestling was a big part of my life, so I would go down to the tournaments in Champaign, Illinois, and see some of his teams wrestle and chatted with him down there a little bit, you know, in the later 70s. Then I have actually seen him a couple of times in a restaurant here or there and said hi to him in my hometown.
Yeah. Do you know anything about this individual that is accusing him, and do you believe these allegations?
Well, I don't know. No, I really don't know who it could be. I have a feeling it was someone a little bit younger than me, maybe later, you know, 79, 80, somewhere in there. But nobody I've talked to has any idea who could have made the allegations, and no, I really don't have any idea.
And you don't believe it, do you?
And I really don't believe it.
So he's going to be arraigned on Thursday. You're going to continue to stand by him?
I believe so, yes. I have no reason not to at this point until we know more.
Yeah. John Jerabek, thank you very much. I really appreciate you coming on.
Thanks, Don. Appreciate it.